What's going on, y'all? This is going to be the first of many thanks to y'all. Thanks to you. We're going to be getting some Netflix reviews every now and then because, you know, my sister loves Netflix. So I'm going to start it off with something I just finished watching today. Started yesterday, finished today. And it's called Running Out of Time. Now, I love my black people, but these movies have got to stop. Starring Tasha Lee, wow. Starring, because I'm looking at Ron, well, Tasha Smith, Ron Rico, I don't know how you say his name, Lee. Thelma Wash, we're going to get it together. Thelma Hopkins, Kiara Schroeder, Dustin Harnish, Sydney, blah, 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 blah. But the main characters, let's talk about Tasha, Ron Rico, Thelma, and Kiara. Now, I mean, you see people in these other roles, I've seen these people in other roles, and then it's like, you just can't see them in serious roles. Like, for example, Tasha Smith, she's just known as in different movies that I've seen her in, it's just being very loud. And so, in this one, she's playing, you know, a widowed mother, and it just, the acting was just off. It was just off. Then we have Thelma Hopkins. Again, these characters, I've seen them in other film, other TV shows and stuff, and it's like, these roles just don't suit them. Now, anyway, the whole storyline, basically, Tasha Smith, I can't remember her name in the movie right now, but she lost her husband, so it opens up, you know, they're at the funeral. They're coming out of the funeral, and you know, you have the, he was very, is a prominent person, because, you know, you had the news people, you know, covering it. They come out of the funeral, being greeted by this person, that person, then his boss, you know, greets her, and, you know, my condolences, blah, 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 anything you could do, I could do for you, blah, 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 he goes off. Then you see another gentleman come out, obviously someone close to the family, come to find out, it was a close, he worked with her husband, and, you know, offered his condolences. As the boss, now my thing is, like, the boss walks over to the car, and the, Ron, what's his name, Ron Rico, he goes over to him, and, you know, the boss says, you know, you got some big shoes to fill, you know. You know, basically, we're going to get in, you know, we got to meet and talk about the moves you have to make. So, basically, the dude that just died, this guy's going to step in his position. Now, to come to find out as the movie goes on, the guy, the boss man, he's going to be running for president. And Ron Rico would be, you know, in line to be the vice president. So, as this thing is going on, but as I was watching, I'm like, I don't know, something just don't seem right about this boss man or about Ron Rico. It's something just seemed off. I'm like, eh. So, all right, the family heads up to go to, they have a family home, you know, the father just died, so they're going to get away with the mother. The mother's sick, I think she has cancer, and so she's sickly. So they go away to this home. The daughter, you know, you can see, you may think that she's, what word I use? Defiant? No. I don't know what to use of it. Kind of rebellious. You may seem that she's rebellious, but you know, her father just died, but then you come to find out she had an argument with her dad, and she said something to the fact like, you know, go away, I don't want this to do with you. And so he died, and so she feels that he may not believe that she had loved him. So that's the shit she was going through. You know, kids, hey, we go through this shit. Anyway, so you're in the house, you know, they're trying to, you know, get situated, you know, trying to do the morning thing, morning, not morning as in daylight, but M-O-U-R, yeah. So, you see, it's like typical scenes, you know, she in the bed, some music playing, and she reminiscing and back to him, and, you know, I guess the times they used to spend in the bed, blah, blah. Fast forward, boom, doorbell rings, guess who comes? Ron Rico comes in, he's crying and seeming like distraught, and she's like, you know, come in, you know, what's wrong, and blah, blah, blah. She's thinking that it's because her husband just passed away and they were close, that's why he was acting like that. But now, I'm telling you, from the beginning of this movie, I'm like, this dude, something shady about him. So he comes in, and he's like, you know, I wouldn't have done this if they didn't force me to, blah, blah, blah. And then next thing, he goes to the door, opens it up, these masked two men come in, and, you know, Ron Rico's apologizing, you know, I wouldn't have brought him here if they didn't make me do it, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, yo, first, I'm like, who wrote this shit? Because, dude, now, if if you're being held hostage, right, and someone's forcing you to do something, how are you going to enter a place and they're going to come in after you? The door's closed. They would be behind you forcing you. I've seen a lot of movies. Who does that? I'm going to come in. Who does that? Anyway, so basically these dudes are trying to find a file. First, you know, Tasha thought, I'm using their real names, not them in the movie. You know, you can look that up if you want to. She was like, you know, the safe is there, you know, you would take whatever's in there. But they were looking for a specific file. Come to find out this file, they traced back, you know, in the movie to show you what this file was. They found out that the head man, the boss man I talked about in the beginning, he was in, you know, had offshore accounts and was embezzling money and using it, getting kickbacks from the jails and then using that same money to fund this campaign. You know, dirty politics, basic shit. So they needed that file because, you know, the husband that died was going to turn him in. And Ron Rico, supposedly his friend, you know, when he had came in, confided him to tell him what he had found, he was like, you know, this could be a big break for us. But her husband, who died, but later we find out he was murdered, he wanted to do the right thing. So, you know, that good and bad fight, hey. But, so, basically throughout the, you have the typical hostage thing, you know, he's threatening to kill the daughter, you know, to kill their daughter, kill her, they don't tell him where the file is, and she's like, I don't know where the file is. The movie goes on, and then come and find, you know, boom, miraculously she remembers that, oh, she got a call from her lawyer that her husband had left her a package, and she was like, you know, and this is the clip they flip back to, you know, her reminiscing, and it's like, she was like, is it in the will? And he's like, no, so it's just a package. So she was like, oh, that must be the package that they're looking for. So they thought she was trying to stall him by time, but in actuality, it was actually the file that the lawyer had. So, moving right along, it was typical hostage thing. Oh, da 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 da. The daughter got freed at one point. You know, rubbing the they were tied up, rubbed it on nails, and got away to go get, you know, she told her, go get your grandmother's phone, because the grandmother was knocked out in the bed because she had mixed her medication with some alcohol. Yeah, she was knocked out. So she's like, go get the phone, call 911. Boom. She got away, was able to get the phone, dial 911, but the phone went dead. But, you know, if you dial 911, you know, it can still trace back, and, you know, and it's being that, you know, she was asking for help. Of course, you know, the cops were dispatched. They came. When the cops came, the robbers, the thieves, whatever the heck you want to call them, the bad guys, they was like, you know, get rid of them. So she did a good job at, you know, getting the cops to leave. You know, I thought, you know, oh, maybe they were gonna, you know, fit, you know, like they said in the movie, maybe they're gonna trace the vehicles, the plates of the car. Nothing like that happened. The cops went about their business. I'm like, what kind of shit is this? You get a call, who writes this shit? So, fast forward, she got the file, and the daughter's left at the house. The daughter's left at the house with one of those two bad guys, and there was three. Well, there's two bad guys, including Ron Rico, because at first he was acting like he was taking hostage as well, but he was the mastermind behind the whole scheme. And he also shot his wife because his wife and her husband, they were trying to do the right thing. She's a reporter, so she was going to report it, you know, make it, put it in the news, and he was going to, you know, take the file to the police. So he killed both of them. All because he's trying to be vice president in a few years, that he could be president. Corrupt political shit. Nothing new. Now, to me, why the acting was just mediocre. If you'd have taken different actors and put in this, I think I would have enjoyed it better. Like, I wonder who. Let me see if I was to cast this myself. If I was to cast this. And keeping it as an all-black cast, just need some more. You know, I would even have put, because I mean, this movie is kind of reminds me of the one that Halle Berry did. Halle Berry did when, you know, what's the name of that? Something that he's like, you know, don't mess with my family and my something. I can't remember. It's like a similar kind of storyline. That's another thing with black movies. Like, get me some more blinking storylines. It's just, ugh. And Thelma Hopkins, it was just, the acting was just horrible. Just horrible. I watched the whole thing. Wouldn't watch it again. Wouldn't recommend it either. Nah. So, I'm going to be giving these things, I'm going to just do thumbs up, thumbs down. Thumbs down. Thumbs down. Anyway, guys, hope y'all enjoyed this. See y'all in the next one.